and, you know, how far we are along in the process. And then how will we, I think it's going to be interesting to define some of the things in the way that we can say to them the direct services that come from certain areas that we decided to emphasize. So two questions, and I don't mean to be negative, but I think for students in particular, it's important for them to feel that they're brought out for a reason and that they can truly have an impact.
I do believe that all the voices that we collect in the LCAP process, well, I definitely have staff voice them in the same way as a lot of executive bodies and administrative bodies collect, let's say, there's a law passed by Congress, the executive then gets a public opinion on the law and the implementation side. I believe we're doing that process with our LCAP. It doesn't, it's a qualitative process, it's somewhat subjective, but if there are areas where we identify a noticeable element that the public has identified, in particular our youth, I think we have to give them greater weight because they're the ones actually experiencing. We can make adjustments and changes, and you know, we have our own ideas of what might work. They may not have the full picture, but they're the ones experiencing it, so they're going to give us probably more meaningful qualitative feedback than almost any other one.
If I may add, I think they have just as much opportunity as everybody else does, given where we're at in the process. Even our board, we're far along in considering the adjustments that we need to make. And I think the most important thing is we give our youth their space to feel that they can respond, as the person said. And then empower them to know that we're going to keep doing this every 3 years. There will be opportunity in their experience to grow that impact on that partnership. But your concern, I think, is really sets a tone around.